Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we're going to create Bedroom Trap. We're on the Razer Blade Pro. Gives me a nice screen where I can see everything. We're going to create Bedroom Trap. So I wrote down the elements of Bedroom Trap. We have a swell bass, a Moog style swelling bass. We have light percussion. We have no auto-tune vocals. So I'm going to be trying to sing during this video a little bit. We're going to have atmosphere, like a low-pass filtered atmosphere type of sound. We're going to have reverse cymbal transitions, swell chords, like a dancey style 909 type of kick, 808 bass. Let me turn my mic down. I'm super loud. And it's weird hearing myself so loud. So let's turn that down. Then we have a 909 kick, as well as, you know, we can try to squeeze in an 808 bass. It really depends on how well we're building the track. And then the vocal vibrato. So that's what we're going to use today. So let's start with creating these sounds. Let's start with a Moog sound that swells. Let's right click and replace this with Harmore. And I'm going to keep everything as simple as possible. So in Harmore, we have a nice big screen. I'm going to turn the unison to 4 or 8. Now we start on a saw wave, which is great. Bars. Let's click that. This open here so we can analyze what's going on. Let's add this low pass filter. We're going to pull back the frequency knob to really muffle that sound. Another thing we're going to do is drop this an octave lower. We're going to go to the pitch area, go to frequency, and put 1/2. That basically halves the octave. Now we have a nice low octave. I'm going to go 1/4 just so in that really low octave. Okay, and if you want to make it different, you just use your unison pan, depending on how wide you want the actual sound. Let's keep it fairly narrow, under 50%. Now another knob you can move is the pitch knob here. Gonna make it more detuned or less detuned. I like it somewhere around 50%. Okay, so now we have those frequencies created. Let's add that to the mixer. Let's send that to track 1. Now one more function. I want to go to Harmore. I want to go to the wrench tool and make sure we have monophonic mode on. This allows me to play one note at a time, so the notes won't overlap and get messy. So for Bedroom Trap, let's right click and tap it out. So we're probably at 140. Let me just actually, I came up with like a little melody. So before I forget the melody, let me arm my mic to be a little lighter. All right, so now I sound a little more lightweight. That's because I don't want to pick up the bass frequencies in my voice. So I had to turn my high pass filter on my microphone. So now I'm going to turn on the metronome so I can keep count. We're going to go to the microphone, arm disc for recording. You know, I have this kind of melody in my head. Now, I'm going to get certain parts right, certain parts wrong. That's fine. We can always go back and make it sound cooler. Let's just hit record. Audio into playlist as an audio clip. Okay, so the BPM is way faster than I assumed. Let's right click and tap it out. So let's do 120 BPM instead. 140 was way too fast for me. Let's hit record once more. Audio into playlist as an audio clip.
Life tendies. Life guarantees. This life on the knees. Life guarantees.
So let's make that random vocal idea sound cooler. Firstly, let's go to our channel rack. Go to change this to all. And this is the vocal recording. Let's send this to track 2. One part about Bedroom, let me turn my mic back on the way it was. Give me one sec. One thing about Bedroom Trap is that it uses a lot of, you know, tons and tons of reverb. So what I'm going to do is set up a reverb on track 100. Let's rename this Aux Verb. And let's pull up Fruity Reverb 2. It's important we turn down the dry level, okay, and turn up the wet level to 100%. You can crank it all the way if you want. It doesn't really matter. And let's set some parameters here. Let's pull our decay time up a bit to about 6 seconds. It's a really long reverb time. Let's pull back the bass. I like to pull back the bass so I don't have bass frequencies cluttering up the reverb. And let's use the low cut to cut out frequencies below, let's say, 300 hertz or so, somewhere around there. And I like to widen the stereo separation. So I like to left click the stereo knob and pull that to stereo so it widens up the reverb response. Let's go to our track on our vocal on track two. So we can chop it and mix it. I just had a rough idea. What I'm going to do firstly is add Fruity Chorus just to make it a little more loose. And what I'm going to do is pull back the mix level. Just until I can barely hear it.
Life guaranteed.
It's going to add a little width to the vocal. Let's also add Fruity Delay Bank. Underutilized plugin here. Let's go to bank one. Turn that on. Turn it to left pan. And I like to take off tempo timing and just pick some random time, 435. Let's go to delay bank two. Let's pan that right. And let's turn off tempo panning and just turn it to a different time. Okay, so now we're going to have a very unique delay. Now it's a little lagged. So I'm going to pull back the times about half.
On our knees, life guarantees.
And you can pull back the mix level as well with a wet level, or you can use the knob.
Life guarantees.
So it adds a like
this life
vintage
on our knees, life guarantees.
Now what I'm going to do is filter my voice. So let's add parametric EQ too. Change this shape here, left click, pull it down to a low pass filter and just muffle out
this
the sound
life on the knees.
So we can barely tell what I'm saying.
Life guarantees.
Let's send that life track two. Let's click on that and let's send it to the aux verb by just left clicking.
Life guarantees. This life on the knees. Life guarantees.
So now we have something in the background. Now I'm going to increase the decay time of the reverb a bit more.
Life guarantees.
And the size of the room.
This life on the knees. Life guarantees.
Okay, so we can kind of mess around with that as you like. That's just something to kind of help us build the track. So let's go to pattern one. Let's add this into the playlist. Let's click up top here. Go to pattern one. So we have pattern one selected. Let's drag that out for four bars. Now I'm going to try and match the tone of the vocal. It's okay if it doesn't match for a lot of different reasons, because I didn't tune my vocals or anything. But let's right click, go to piano roll, and draw in notes as we go. Now it's hard to hear this, so I like to play in higher octaves. Now it's going to sound very high pitched now, but we're going to pull the pitch down in a second. Let's also turn this down in the mix. Now my vocal's not tuned to 440 hertz, so don't worry about the vocal right now. So 1, 2, 3, boom. So let's do that. So sometimes you have to do it by your mind. Your mind's telling you what to play. All right, let's hit control down twice to pull that down two octaves. So let's hear what we have. Doesn't matter if the vocal matches or not. We can always redo the vocal idea. I like that bass. So let me turn off the vocal for now. So now we have something to build off of, an idea to build off of. Let's go to pattern two and let's just go down our checklist. So that was the Moog style bass. Now also the Moog, we're going to have it swell. To do that, we're going to open up Harmore. We're going to click here and go to volume under articulation envelope. Give it, turn the envelope on by clicking that button down here. It's going to give it an attack time and pull everything up to the top here and pull your release over and just pull everything to the max. So you just want to give it this attack curvature. If you're still confused about sound design, just go to busyworksbeats.com/sound design. We have a whole free course. So that creates a swell effect. And that's what gives it half its emotion. Now we need some light percussion. So let's go to our browser. Let's go to PEX, let's go to Drums by Mode Audio, and let's go to their percussion and their Foley sounds. I'd start with percussion first, and let's just see some lightweight percussion we can add. So I like the snap. We're definitely using the snap. Let's send snap to track 3. And let's put the snap on the 2 and the 4 count. Actually, excuse me, we're in double time, so the 3 and the 7 count. When we're doing trap music, we're usually making our drums feel as though they're half the BPM. To do that, instead of putting the drums on the 2 and 4 count, which is if you turn on the metronome, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, we're going to put them on the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So we're going to put them on the 3 and the 7 versus the 2 and the 4 count. Make sure we draw this out correctly in the playlist. I like these weird tap sounds. Dum, dum. So I'm going to add that to the snare pattern. See what else we can find. You want to stay away from like the tonal stuff, stuff that has a pitch to it. Most of these have pitches to them. It's weird, but it could work. I like this one here. So let's add it. Now, usually I put my percussion on a different track, but we're not going to focus on that too much. See what else we can find. I like this one here. Now for this, I'm going to right click and take off cut itself because I want the samples to overlap. So I want to go boom, ticka ticka boom. So 1, 1, 2, 3. Now this is a very long sample, however, so I'm going to use the fade out. That's something you don't see a lot when you take off the cut itself. That's probably the one time in about 3 years or 2 years that I've let the sample purposely overlap. But it sounds cool for this genre. Now, if you want to get real technical, you can right click, go to piano roll. Just left click the bottom here to pull up your controls. Go to control, pan for note pan, and you can pan one middle, one left, and one right. So we can create the illusion of delay, even though it's not a delay. Now remember, when you go to piano roll, remember that the last thing you changed, it will save it. So if I add a new note, it will be panned to the right. So just make sure you click on a note that has all the standard stuff on it, if you're wondering. Let's right click. So just weird sounds. Let's add this on the and. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now for this sound, it sounds a little early to me, so let's go to the wrench tool and use that time shift to pull that up a bit. Let's turn that down in volume. You can be as quirky as you want with the percussion. Let's see what else we can add. I'm thinking some claps. I'm probably do like a British thing, even though I'm not British. Let's go to our mixer. I'm going to start sending stuff to the reverb. Let's click on that clap. Pull my mixer. And just left click the track 100 where we set up the reverb. So here, I'm going to add sound. It's very stagnant, but I'm going to go to plugins. Let's go to Fruity. Where is it at? Fruity Panomatic. Let's tell it to be a triangle shape and tell it to control the pan. And let's turn the amount up and speed up. So it moves around. Turn the speed down a bit. So you can actually hear it pan left and right. I'm I'm also going to send that to the reverb. Just left click. Reverb is an instrument. Don't forget. Let's turn this down just a bit. Let me get rid of that first vocal because I know it's not going to make sense in this track. I'm going to go back to Harmore and just add a couple things like resonance and lower the frequency just a bit. Okay, so we have the light percussion, we have the bass. Alright, now we need an atmospheric sound, so let's right click and replace this with Harmore. Let's go to Citrus actually, I just want to see what pad sounds they have. Let's right click, we're going to use presets here, so let's see what we have under the, where are we at? Do they have a pad? Here we go, pads. Just gonna use the arrows to cycle through the presets. Now to figure out the chords here, we have to use some music theory. So let's figure it out. Firstly, let's turn this down. I do like that movement. Let's just go to another pad. I like the softness here. So I might not use chords, but let's just see. Let's add this to the playlist. Let's right click. So we're gonna start with a note D and then we're gonna switch to F. Now we have to figure out which chord we're going to use. It's probably going to be a G major. But let's go to G minor. Sounds a little dark. So let's do... I'm using a lot of different thought processes here. I know I'm skipping over them, but we may not need a chord. Just use fifths here. Let's pull that down in volume. I'm also going to pull this down an octave. Let's hit control down. Sounds too like shimmery. Technically, this isn't the fifth. It's the fourth, and then we're using... Let's do it this way. But that sounds too happy, so I'm going to pull it down to A. Switch out the preset. I'm just going to switch the presets until I get the right feel. I like this one here. That sounded really good. Now it seems like it's might be adding a chord. I can't really tell. I like the tension in that second half. Either way, this doesn't need to be the focal point. That's the one thing about Bedroom Trap. The background pad is like just something in the background. Now we need a reverse cymbal. So let's go to drums by mode audio. Let's go to cymbals. We need a nice long cymbal. Let's see what we can find here. Right click, open that up in new channel. Let's right click and clone that. So let's send these to tracks 11 and 12. Actually, both track 11, they're the same thing. Click on the second sample. Let's go to reverse. We're going to go to mode, E3 generic, and we're going to time stretch it by right-clicking time to 2 bars. If that sounds too fake, just right-click and half that. So go to 1 bar. That sounds more realistic. Let's go to pattern. Actually, we don't need to even switch patterns. Let's just add it 1 bar over. So one's going backwards for a bar, then the other one's hitting forward for a bar. Let's add that at the transition point. And let's turn that down in the mix and add Fruity Delay to spice it up a bit. I'm just going to go to ping pong mode on Fruity Delay 2. Set the time to either 3 or 4, doesn't matter. And then we're going to send that to the reverb, of course. We have our cymbal. We have swelling chords, basically the ambience. But what I can do here is copy the chords. Hit Control C. Let's just, for the swell chords, let's right click, replace this with Harmore. And we're going to do basically the same patch, very simple. This time, let's go to voices. Let's turn it up to about 4. Let's paste this in. Let's hit Control V. In the channel rack. Let's send this to track 12. I'm gonna turn this down because it's gonna be super loud right now. And what I wanna do is go to the volume, activate it, and again, turn everything up and then pull your release over so that it just swells in attack. And I like to put it on tempo mode and snap to grid so I can snap it to the tempo. So we can predict how long it takes. Since these are longer chords, I'm going to drag it out. And I'm going to pull down that low pass filter. That's why I think the ambience has a chord to it. It must have a different tone in here because it sounds like 3 to 1. So that's a different tone. So I'm going to switch this preset out because it's creating an illusion of a different note that's not there. Now we're listening to Harmore. Let's add a little vibrato. Turn the speed up, which slows it down. Give it 10 cents of vibrato, very subtle. Let's turn citrus back on. Go through presets. I like the movement in this one. It's pretty cool. Just turn down our pad a bit from Harmore. So you don't have to have them both going. Let's hit Control X. Let's go to a new pattern. And let's hit Control V to paste that into pattern 5 so we can have that build over time. Kind of hard to hear both pads, so I'm going to hit Control up so one pad's an octave separated from the next. Then we're going to turn that down. So now it's just balancing the two. I'm gonna send that to the Reverb, our new pad in Harmo. Let's go into the browser. Let's grab a kick. Let's go to kicks. Where are we at here? Kicks. I like attack kick 12. Let's open that up a new channel. Send that to track 13. Create any pattern you want. Add this to the playlist. Let's hit stop. Let's go all the way back. Now the trick here, what I'm going to do is add the kick right before the snare. So boom, boom, ch. Get rid of the Moog bass during the second half and see if we can find an 808 to layer over top the kick. Let's go to kicks. I think they have some 808s in here somewhere. Just right click, open that up. I could use it as is. Let's get rid of pattern 6. Whoops, didn't mean to click that. Let's add this pattern 7 and let's just create a kick pattern for the bass, but we're going to change the notes later. Turn it down. Make sure it matches your rhythm. So what we're going to do is go to pattern 2, make that unique, and take out that noise right before the snare. Let's change all these to pattern 3. That doop doop. Let's just get rid of that for the 808 section. And I'm just going to leave the 808 as is, same note and everything. Let's go to our mixer. Let's add a little Fruity Blood overdrive. Turn down post gain and turn up preamp a bit. Might make it too distorted, actually. Never mind, let's just leave it as it was. It's fine. Now what I'm gonna do is introduce a different snare. When I introduce the 808, let's grab a snare. Let's right click, open that up. Send the track 15. Let's add that snare on the 3 and the 7 count. Need to pitch the snare, pitch it down a bit. Of course, we need to go to our mixer and send that to the Reverb. I think one more cool thing we could do just to wrap this up is to copy our chords and add an arpeggio. Let's hit Control C. Create an arpeggio. Let's go to Harmore. And where are we at? Where is Harmore? Here we go. Harmore. Send that to track 16. To Control V to paste the chords in. Let's just add them all the way through. What I'm going to do here is go to the wrench tool to create an arpeggio. Let's hit the up button. Let's tell it to have a range of 3 octaves. Let's turn this down. You can create whatever arpeggio you want. Let's go to chord auto. I like auto sustain. It's pretty cool. So now I'm going to shape the actual sound. Let's add a little pluck time to it. Now I want it to pan left and right, just like our I forgot what's pan and left, that cymbal hit, the percussion hit. So let's add Fruity Panomatic. Triangle wave, it's gonna pan, mount up, speed up. I'm just gonna turn it up a little bit and then send it to the reverb. Let's see what happens if I add the kick. Patterns don't match up. Let's make this unique. Just change that pattern up a bit. Get rid of that extra kick. I like that kind of play off the bass. I like that. Down. Also for the ARP, let's click there, let's edit pattern. Just hit control down so it plays an octave lower. That way we can have it play louder. And I'm gonna get rid of one of the pads so it's in too claw, too much sound. Go back and add a vocal idea, something really light. But before I do that, let's open up Maximus. Just right click, go to default. Whoops. Make sure we're not compressing anything. Let's work on these stereo bands. Pull the bass in mono. Let's go to bands. Make sure we're at about, I'm trying to look at the frequency here. Go to about 150 to make that the low frequencies. Go back to low. Make sure we're pulling that in mono. Let's go to mid. Make those a little wider, then the highs a little wider as well. So this stuff has space. Now I'm gonna add a vocal idea. So I'm gonna arm the track for recording. Just record random melodic ideas. Saying nonsense words, but we're gonna do some things to those. Okay, we're gonna do some stuff to that vocal track. Let's send that track to track, send that vocal to track 17. First I'm gonna go to Fruity Shape, Stereo Shaper. just delay it a bit. I'm gonna add the fruity delay bank that I had. Where was that at? Track one of these, track two. I'm gonna copy that. Hit the down arrow, just save preset as, drag it over to the track you want. Send that to the reverb. I know it's a rough idea for a vocal, but so I'm gonna keep that part. That's it. So let's snap the grid beat. Let's just zoom in. Just gonna keep the breath parts. Let's cut out everything else. And I think that would be a good way, a good place to end this video right after I cut these vocals. Since some are good, some are bad, I'm just going to copy these over, hitting shift. Make sure you snap the grids on bar mode. The 808, I'm going to add an EQ. Use a low pass filter to get rid of some of that clicky sound. Let's move that transition for the cymbal. Louder than they were. Let's turn that off. Swap the mode back in, see how it fits. Yeah, the grips the ear a lot better. Turn my vocals down. Very basic right here on the Razer Blade Pro. You can see right in FL Studio. Keep it basic as possible. I wanted to use only FL Studio stuff. So if you want to continue the series, just make sure you're following along right here on YouTube. Thanks for watching. It's BusyWorksBeats.com. If you want these project files for free, just click that link below and be sure to get these project files for free. It's BusyWorksBeats.com. Create complete compositions with comprehension. Master music theory. Visit BusyWorksBeats.com/music theory for your free bonuses and free music theory tutorials. Professional mixing secrets finally revealed. Get 3 free videos straight from the new Mixing Academy complete course package at BusyWorksBeats.com/Mac. Want to learn how to make beats like the pros? Join now for free at BusyWorksBeats.com and learn the secrets of the pros.